Hi guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. Before watching the video, please subscribe to my channel. This video is about Dogecoin is getting important signals from whales. So Dogecoin whales are buying the dip amid the ongoing crypto market meltdown. And this is what I'm going to talk about in this video. But before coming to it, let's see some important updates from the crypto world. So MEX Global, one of the world's largest digital asset and crypto exchanges, has recently announced that it will list Nervo's native token in order to facilitate future token listings for businesses built on the Nervo's network. MEX Global will incorporate Nervo's simple user-defined token into its trading platform, enabling users to get access to cross-border projects in Asia, Europe, and America. And it is expected that this development will pave the way for other cryptos to be listed on the trading platform. Meanwhile, three German political parties have advocated the creation of a regulatory framework for crypto and the blockchain technology industry in the European Union. According to the official announcement, the plan calls for broader regulation and oversight of crypto assets by all European Union organizations. It states that the EU regulatory authorities should not only monitor the traditional financial sector but also prevent the misuse of crypto assets for money laundering and terrorist financing while regulating it widely. In short, this coalition agreement calls for a broader regulatory and supervisory framework for crypto in Europe, which I feel is a positive move for the crypto industry. And now coming to the next update, there is great news for Shiba-Inu fans as electronics retailer Newegg has confirmed that it will accept Shiba-Inu soon. So we saw rumors about Newegg adding Shiba-Inu to its list of crypto payment alternatives last week when Newegg tagged two Shiba-Inu Twitter accounts and requested a direct message. And now Newegg has made it official that they are going to adopt SHIB as a payment alternative on their platform. So this development is definitely going to cheer Shiba Inu holders, especially when they are worried about the ongoing market crash that forced Shiba Inu to plummet by almost 60%. And now, let's come to the big update for Dogecoin. So according to smart contract activity, major whales are buying Dogecoin on the dip. For those who don't know, smart contract activity is one of the indirect methods for determining the number of actions that occur on chain with respect to one or more assets. And Dogecoin has joined the top 10 most actively used smart contracts on the Ethereum blockchain. As per reports, Doge was ranked 7th among the most actively interacted smart contracts on the chain. And it was ranked with coins such as Binance Smart Chain, BNB, and Chia Coin. Now it is believed that the implementation of smart contracts typically results in greater purchasing activity, as users must hold a specific amount of tokens or coins in order to access the coin smart contract. And the higher on-chain activity indicates increased demand for Dogecoin. Additionally, it demonstrates that the Dogecoin smart contract is experiencing active user involvement, generating purchasing activity for it. Similarly, on-chain data for Bitcoin indicates that whales account for approximately 90% of the funds sent to exchanges. In addition, it appears that the big whales are also very much interested in cryptos amid the current market-wide correction. So as the global markets continue to fall, one crypto whale is buying Bitcoin in large quantities. According to BitInfoCharts, a single wallet has accumulated around 6,800 Bitcoin since November 8th. The holder has added around $411 million to an already large bag. The data also revealed that the wallet currently has almost 114,000 Bitcoin in its hands with a total worth around $6 billion, making it the largest known Bitcoin wallet in existence. So it is evident that despite the fact that the overall crypto market has been on the downside during November, investors and whales are not worried about the current market decline. And I think it is a positive sign that they are becoming still interested in crypto since it will propel the overall market to get huge gains in the near future. Now this rise of whales' interest in Bitcoin is also important for Dogecoin since Dogecoin's correlation with Bitcoin has increased to 0.88, up dramatically from 0.5 last week and 0.7 just yesterday. And I believe that investors' interest in Bitcoin is equally important for Dogecoin, as a positive outlook for Bitcoin implies that Dogecoin is equally bullish. So I believe that a bull run for Bitcoin implies a bull run for Dogecoin as well. And there can be no dispute that both coins are equally valuable as an asset class and as a medium of exchange. As a result, it's very obvious that if Bitcoin sees a substantial price increase, Dogecoin will almost certainly follow suit. So El Salvador, the first country to adopt Bitcoin, has maintained its Bitcoin history by purchasing the dip during the recent market crash. President Nayib Bukele recently stated on Twitter that they had purchased an additional 100 Bitcoin tokens, referring to it as a Black Friday sale. In addition, El Salvador now owns roughly 1,100 Bitcoin tokens, after making the first purchase in September. Now we know that this recent crypto market flash crash saw major coins lose double digits and virtually all of their gains from October's bull run. Bitcoin plummeted below the critical $55,000 support level, and the entire market lost roughly $700 million. But it appears that even as panic set in as liquidations began, El Salvador took advantage of the opportunity to add a few more bitcoins to its treasury at a discounted rate in what people are calling the Black Friday sale. Meanwhile, El Salvador also launched Bitcoin-backed bonds recently in order to facilitate the much-anticipated Bitcoin City initiative. And due to this, the dollar-backed bonds in the country have plummeted significantly. And seeing this, the IMF has slammed El Salvador for its decision to adopt Bitcoin. Now the IMF is not alone in slamming El Salvador's adoption of Bitcoin. Andrew Bailey, the governor of the Bank of England, has also expressed concern for El Salvador's citizens following the country's adoption of Bitcoin as legal tender. Bailey expressed alarm about the drive to include Bitcoin into a dual currency system, while also noting that volatility would be most destructive to El Salvador's financial system. However, we are seeing that El Salvador has demonstrated its unwavering commitment to Bitcoin by ignoring multiple warnings from the IMF, the World Bank, and other institutions. The government has demonstrated that these international organizations were incorrect when they projected a total collapse of the currency with Bitcoin as legal tender. Indeed, it turned out that Bitcoin aided El Salvador in ending its reliance on the IMF for external assistance. So I think that El Salvador is going to be a case study for other worlds. And since it has ended its reliance on IMF's funding by adopting Bitcoin, I think if it turns out fruitful over the long term, other countries will follow suit. Since this step will make their economies independent from these institutions like the IMF. Anyway, what are your thoughts on this? Do you think that other nations will also adopt crypto as legal tender? Let me know in the comments section below. And now coming to the next update. The crypto adoption in Australia has been rising since the latest survey reveals that Aussies are looking to have a very merry crypto-giving Christmas this year. So according to a recent survey on Australian consumers' findings produced by Crypto.com, many people in the country are incorporating crypto into their daily life. Over 2,000 people between the ages of 18 and 59 were surveyed. And it has been revealed that around 65% believe crypto can be used for purposes other than investment. While 26% of respondents who have used crypto in the previous 12 months indicated that they would consider giving some away for Christmas or purchasing crypto-related gifts. Seeing this, I think that Australia as a whole is experiencing an unprecedented increase in interest in cryptos. And I see it beneficial for the crypto industry, particularly given the ongoing global market crisis. Meanwhile, Bobby Lee, CEO of crypto wallet company Ballet, has recently stated that the crypto market has not yet reached the Bitcoin apex or cycle peak. He said that he believes Bitcoin is extremely likely to reach and surpass the 150K or 200K peak before the end of the year or early next year. And when asked what he believes will be the impetus for Bitcoin's rapid rise to 200K, Bobby Lee identified regulatory framework and widespread acceptance as the primary price drivers. According to him, over 100 million people own Bitcoin and other cryptos, despite the fact that the asset class is not well reported across social media platforms and by traditional financial systems. Now seeing his remarks, I think that with the passage of time and the outcome of crypto market events, market spectators and investors are discovering further reasons to be bullish as Bitcoin's adoption rate continues to accelerate. However, we know that the crypto market is currently on the downside, so it is a matter of time if all these bullish predictions come true or not. And now let's come back to Dogecoin. So Doge is currently trapped in a consolidation phase as it continues to print lower highs and lower lows. However, Doge can reverse the period of sluggish performance, if bulls can slice above the 20 cents price level. And above this level, additional resistances can appear at the 21 and 22 cents price levels. However, escaping above these resistances could see Dogecoin's momentum shift to the upside, potentially targeting bigger aspirations. If you liked the video, please subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching.